JBN special feature, Jamaican Treasures. Wolmer's defender, Gregory Bryce. Not just a star on the field, but also in class. Please remember to like, subscribe, share, leave a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our weekly feature, Jamaican Treasures. With 11 subjects and being a part of a promising Wolmer's Boys Manning Cup team, Gregory Bryce is a parent's dream child and one who exemplifies the qualities of the outstanding student athlete. Bryce, who plays left back on the Wolmer's team that topped their group, then brushed aside Denham Town in the second round, has 8 CSEC and 3 CAPE subjects, but believes that being called a student athlete can be a setback. "I feel the stigma of being labeled a student athlete sometimes discourages the athletes from trying to expand from that area of expertise and limits them somewhat," he said. "If I get a cent for every time that I've been told, 'Oh, you're a balla, but you're so bright,' I'd probably be a billionaire by now. I think persons like Justin Morin is an inspiration to athletes like myself," said Bryce. Morin represented St. George's College and is now the CEO of Digicel, which sponsors the corporate area Manning Cup schoolboy football competition. "It truly is an inspiration to see such a successful figure have a history playing in this competition, as it makes it clear that being a footballer isn't a deterrent to having success outside of the sport," said Bryce. He said balancing his studies and football is key in doing well in both. "I try to manage my time as efficiently as possible. At the heart of the matter is truly down to time management," said young Bryce, who's normally in class from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., trains from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m., and then reaches home by 7 p.m. "If I have the energy available, and I'll try my best to put in as much work in whatever assignments I might have, but if not, I'll go to sleep and wake up an hour or two earlier to try and complete it. Obviously, this isn't a perfect situation, but it's what works for me. It does leave me lethargic during the day sometimes, and I often end up sleeping during my class sessions," said Bryce. The young Wolmerian, who admires former St. George's star Cardell Benbow and Manchester City midfielder Kevin De Bruyne as his two favorite players, plans to enter the field of journalism. "I have a passion for writing, and it's my aim to get into the University of the West Indies through a scholarship and enter the Faculty of Humanities and gain my bachelor's degree in journalism. I would very much prefer to study at a local tertiary level institution rather than to travel overseas. I also have the ambition of perhaps penning my own novel in the near future, hopefully with major success," he pointed out. Wolmers, who won the last of their 10 Manning Cup titles in 1994, have a very good chance of ending that 24-year drought, and Bryce believes the time is near. "I think the sky's the limit. At this point in time, I think it's acceptable for us to allow ourselves to dream of success, but we'll keep ourselves grounded firmly in reality as well," said Bryce. "If it were easy, then we'd have won it already, but nothing easy is ever truly worthwhile. Like our coach tells us all the time, it's one game at a time, and we should enjoy our football, and once we follow that mantra, I believe we can come out as champions," he added. JBN special feature, Jamaican Treasures, where we feature young Jamaicans who we know will make a positive influence in the future. Please remember to like, subscribe, share, leave a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.